how did he kind of settle down after the first inning and get to the kind of rhythm?
Yeah, he came out. He, you know, all weekend long, our guys said that the mound was a little bit difficult to get used to. It was a little bit of a flatter mound than we're used to, and that wasn't an excuse that we're using, but you saw early on for each guy, their velocity wasn't up, and they were a little bit up in the zone, and I prepared him for that, and I think he was fighting through that, but boy, he started getting into a mode, and he started being down. We let his fastball work for him, and he had his good breaking ball, and that's a big game for us, a huge game for us. We needed to salvage that game like we weren't able to do last weekend.
How much do you think he kind of relishes that role of being the stopper, of being a guy that can come in?
Well, on Sundays, he's our closer, he's our middle guy, and he's our stopper. And he's also our other stopper, too. But, you know, I just told the team how this game works is what no one realized, and I didn't tell anyone in the dugout. Last weekend, we were up 3-1 on Ole Miss in the ninth inning with Godley going out. He was at 94 pitches, and we had a 2-run lead. This weekend, we're up 4-2. Godley went out in the ninth inning at 94 pitches. And the game was almost testing us. Can you do this? Can you get it done this time? And it was the same scenario. Their leadoff hitter comes up. We go fastball, strike one, like we did last week against Hunter. Their leadoff hitter, breaking ball in the dirt, 1-1. Last weekend, the guy doubled on the third pitch. This weekend, the guy hooked a foul. And we were able to overcome that ninth inning because Zach walks the guy. But those kind of little things are huge for a team that's trying to find an identity and find a way to win games.
When you went out and talked to him, what did you kind of tell him at that point?
I told him I was already bald enough, gray enough, and fat enough that I didn't need any more. And he said, I know, Coach. And I just wanted to slow him down. He was starting to rush a little bit, and obviously he responded and threw the next pitch for a strike, but they popped up. But I tried to relax the situation out there with him and the rest of the guys because we've gone through some tough times, and those parts of the games haven't been very favorable to us, and I just wanted to relax.
How about offensively today? It seemed like it was a day where you guys took advantage of some opportunities.
Yeah, we did. You know, one of the bigger hits in the game was Derek Lance with a runner on second. He tries to steal first and drag, and then Coach Berge just told him to get it done anyway, and he hits the ball down the right field line. And you know, again, for the second time in three weekends, we don't have our three-hole hitter, Scott Price, in there, and we find a way to win as a team, and that's what I tried to explain to this team. And it doesn't matter who's in the lineup. If we're doing things as a team, we can overcome any obstacle.
Bennett was a guy that, you moved him up to cleanup. He had a home run early, and then you took him out. Was there something wrong with him?
He has a pulled quad that happened the other night, and he re-aggravated on that when he made his turn at first base, and we have some guys down right now, and we just couldn't afford to push the envelope. And that was a big run to score, and we needed to get a little bit more speed, especially with his quad bothering.
What was the reason why you kind of shift around the lineup a little bit today?
Well, because we have Stewart's been struggling a little bit, which goes with the territory sometimes with guys, and Price had a lineup. Ethan's going well right now, and I wanted his bat in the middle of the lineup, and so the coaches, and it paid dividends for us.
Talk about throwing a guy like Godley on Sunday. You don't see that a lot in the SEC, throwing the guy that's really been your anchor throughout SEC play on Sundays. What's your strategy behind that?
Well, hopefully we could win a game on Friday or Saturday. We had a chance yesterday, and we weren't able to. We got a great start from Nick Williams. We feel pretty good about going into Sunday. We haven't had a lot of success on Fridays when Godley was even pitching for us because he's matching up against pretty good guys. And I talked to the team before I made this decision. This isn't all about me. It's about us. And I wanted them to be aware of what our goal was. And that was our goal was to get to the SEC tournament and get to Booty. And we felt this was the best formula for that success. And again, this Sunday game is a big win for us to salvage a game and move up a little bit in what our chase is.
And just your impressions of Florida after this weekend. Obviously.